Guys, let's go into my top five reasons why people fail at carnivore and ketogenic diets. So here we go, and what to do about it. Because these dietary measures are awesome, but people get a lot of misinformation. So, number one, this is not a weight loss diet. When people consider weight loss on, let's say, carnivore, because they think, oh, I'm cutting out the carbs and the bread, and I'm cutting out the fat, and I'm eating a bunch of protein. And if I ca count the macros or the calories, I'm going to be at a caloric deficit and I'm going to lose weight. And they go like, why aren't I losing any more weight? And this is because it's about hormones. And a lot of you guys are coming from damaged hormones or hormonal system prior to even doing these diets. So then when you implement them, the hormones become even more downregulated. For example, your reproductive hormones. You guys are eating a lot of lean meat and not enough animal fat, which is why I've explained many times you have to do a high fat version of carnivore and obviously a high fat version of keto omnivore. If you don't, your body, your cells, the lungs, a lot of parts of your body utilize fat not only for the vitamins but for the protection of cells. And so, or the reproduction of hormones. For example, your sex hormones are made out of cholesterol. And so when you're eating a lot of lean meat and not enough fat, women's menstrual cycles start to get really wonky. They might have them every month, but it starts to shorten or lengthen in days in between, or the actual, you start to have more pain or very light menstrual cycles, which also is a problem from not eating enough fat. Then we have the thyroid hormones, which tend to go haywire. And again, we need cholesterol as fat substrates to make cholesterol, I mean, not just cholesterol, but thyroid hormone. You need your fat soluble vitamins, especially vitamin D, which you're not going to get by eating too much protein. Now, people try to get their fat off the meat, which is not enough because you have to eat pounds and pounds of meat to get enough animal fat, which is why I always say you have to add supplemental animal fat to your diet, like butter or lard or tallow, if you don't have a histamine response to the butter. So people don't consider their hormones and they take out really one of the most important hormonal regulators, which is the animal fat and high amounts of it. And we also have to deal with our blood sugar and our insulin. So people tend to eat a lot of meat. That excess meat gets reconverted back into glucose, and people can't regulate their blood sugar. And then now their insulin is too high, and they're not insulin sensitive. They become insulin resistant on eating too much protein. Yes, that goes for both keto omnivore and carnivore. So if you can eat the moderate to low amount of protein and bring in supplemental fat and raise that fat really high, now you have all the building blocks for hormones that you wouldn't have eating too much meat. The problem also with eating too much meat, which is another problem, is that your body can't use it all. So what it can't use, it reconverts back to blood sugar, sorry. And then the people's blood sugar becomes deregulized or deregulated. And they begin to have sleep problems. They begin to have really, really, really severe cases of hypoglycemia, which is also a part of the hormonal system. So people's blood sugar drops. They have this bolus amount of insulin being pumped out, and their body has the glucagon and insulin balance goes out the door. And people start to just crash and crash with their blood sugar surges. That's another problem. So the way you balance that again is you take down the protein and you up the fat and you chew that stuff slowly. Another thing that people don't consider is the state of their gallbladder. When you need a gallbladder, right? That organ to break down and digest fat. It's going to scrub it down to little particles so it can enter the small intestine and go right into the bloodstream and give us that lovely cholesterol that we need to heal the body and to build the body. And a lot of people just literally don't consider their gallbladder. So you want to consider right side pain, bloated, or just the sense of I can't eat any more fat, even though it's not a lot in sizable amounts. So the way you fix that is you can get an ultrasound. Some people do blood tests, but an ultrasound pretty much will show stones, mostly stones, harder to show sludge. But you can also go by your symptomology, which is, like I said, that bloated pressure, middle stomach, middle to side pain or sense of pressure. Nausea is a big, huge sign of a gallbladder issue, or I just can't eat anymore. And then what you would do to correct that would be to eat slowly. You could also do things like Tutka or ox bile salts to help digest some of those fats because your gallbladder either is not there or you've got sludge or stones. There's also, you can do flushes or cleanses to the whole biliary duct system, which includes the liver, the kidney, and the colon, but you want to stay away from fruits and things. You could possibly do citrus fruits if you don't have a citrus histamine reaction, but not like sweet fruit citrus for the gallbladder. So that's another thing people don't consider. They don't even think about their gallbladder. A lot of people have gooped up gallbladders and they won't know until they eat a lot of fat and then they're like, oh my God, I can't. People use things like magnesium citrate, obviously the citrate portion of the magnesium to try to dissolve stones in the kidney and in the gallbladder. People use things like digestive aids for the short term, like lipase, to help you digest the fat as a digestive enzyme. So another thing that people need to consider when it comes to why people fail, and this is really, really important, is to make the corrections on your life. So we're trying to drive ketogenesis in these low carb ketogenic and carnivore diets. We're trying to drive ketogenesis, and people aren't making their lifestyle adjustments. Like you have to go to bed early because your body is just not going to repair. It doesn't repair very well after midnight, and it like that beautiful sweet spot is between 9 and 12 a.m. That's when the body does its most repair. It loses weight. It does all these corrections and the body begins to heal in those hours, and a lot of people are just simply awake. So you need to go to bed earlier. A lot of you guys need to diaphragmatic breathe and stay away from cell phones and use blue blockers or mouth taping to try to calm down that sympathetic nervous system that's popping like popcorn at night. Because if you can't sleep well and you're tired in the day, it's because your blood sugar is or your cortisol is inverted. It's too high at night, and your melatonin's too low. It's suppressed. The other thing is, you guys have to rotate your foods. You need to rotate because if you have histamine or mast cell activation or SIBO or leaky gut, a lot of people just kind of just eat monofoods all the time. And like on keto, they'll have cheese, which is a high histamine food. The gut wall is not going to heal. I'm filming with my arm, so I can't show you what the gut wall looks like with both hands. And so people don't rotate, don't eat the same thing every day, and stay away from inflammatory foods like cheese, nuts, caffeine, teas that are not loose leaf tea. Make sure that it's an herbal tea and that you don't react to the herb part of it, because a lot of you guys don't react well to the tannins in teas. Don't eat things like fermented foods, no kombucha, no sauerkraut. If you're having a gut dysbiosis, you literally will make it worse. A lot of people need to follow our circadian rhythm and do not work out in the evening because melatonin is trying to secrete, and it just gets suppressed when you don't relax in the evening from 4 on, 3 p.m. on. That's why I like for people to work out in the earlier part of their day. There are so many reasons why people fail, like the electrolytes. People eat 2 pounds of beef, they don't get enough sodium, magnesium, potassium. These are big reasons why people develop like dehydration, constipation, chronic headaches, feeling a sense of just feeling like sick, the heart palps, they're out of control, the muscle cramps, the chronic dehydration, the craving for sugar can be from an electrolyte imbalance. You guys really need to stay off the coffee. You can use DLPA or L-tyrosine as a way to get off. All supplements should be taken for the short term. You have to consider your hypochlorhydria. and the thyroid and find a very calm, safe environment to be in the next 4 weeks of doing these diets to try to correct your hormonal issues, your electrolyte issues, and your hypoglycemia and your sleep issues. There you go, some 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 top reasons and what to do. And don't be afraid to go off these diets if you're having problems and switch to low carb, high fat for the short term until you can go back in. Please get off your caffeine. Please get off the decaf. And I'm out. Guys, I gotta go see my boy Thunder. You guys go check out my boy on Instagram, which is Stephanie Ketogenic and All Solutions. Like, I want to do another video, but I'm running out of time about why transdermal magnesium is so darn important along with your glycinate sublingual on these low carb diets or on any diet, really. Now I gotta go because I got some energy at 53 and I'm still going strong. I'm, was it quasi carnivore, which is mostly carnivore? Because it's just awesome. Awesome for so many reasons people don't realize. The anti-nutrients in plants, the salicylates, the oxalates, the goitrogens, the nightshades, the tannins, lectins, saponins, the tannins, the gluten. Like, it's for real. It's a real thing. I need to go more in depth about it. And yeah, just loving life, guys, even though it's crazy times. It's crazy times. But I'm not crazy. I'm sharp up in here. I also do a course for people who have a difficult time dealing with their hypoglycemia and thyroid issues on keto and carnivore. And so we go low carb, high fat protocol into keto. Yes, I'm going to be doing consultations more, but I'm in the transition of moving. I should have more dates up next month, but go to my website on the CAC contact list and ask to be on the now short long list for consultations, which I will be able to do consultations all day long once I have my horse in my backyard. Yes, so I have a course that goes over all diets, keto, omnivore, carnivore, low carb, high fat. We really go there. And of course, right here on my YouTube channel and on my Instagram, which is Stephanie Ketogenic, and my Facebook, which is Stephanie, the business person.